Wishful thinking, what does that mean? I'll often tell my students, if there's something in life you want, just make it happen and deal with the consequences. Now this applies to the ordinary curriculum. For example, you know, in an algebra question you might need to solve x over 2 plus 1 third equals 1 fifth or something. And the wish here could be, gosh, I wish there weren't any fractions in this problem. In which case, that's what you wish, make it happen. How can we get rid of the fractions? I guess what we'll do is say, multiply through by 2, double everything. So x over 2 times 2 would be x, plus 2 thirds equals 2 fifths. And then if I still don't like my fractions, maybe I could triple everything, and then multiply everything by 5, life would be grand. But engaging in wishful thinking is a great problem-solving strategy in and of itself. For example, here's a very famous problem. It appears in many problem-solving books, and it's believed to originate as an interview question for certain software companies. The idea is, here are three blobs, A, B, C, stuck at the top of the wall here, and three more blobs labeled A, B, C. And the question is, can you connect each A to each pair of A's, each pair of B's, each pair of C's with lines that do not intersect? Try it. Okay, I connect A to A, no worries. I can connect B to B, but I have to go around. And then it seems like I'm stuck about the C's. So you mull on this for a while and feel like you're stuck. So what's a good problem-solving strategy here? Well, engage in wishful thinking. In fact, this problem, I can tell you, would be so much easier if I had A, B, and C as before, the B down the bottom. What I don't like is these A's and C's in that order. I wish they were switched around, because then the problem would be very easy to solve. Okay, well, what does that do for me? Can I now take the answer that was very good and delightful and somehow mold this so the A's and C's actually do merge and come back around to where they're meant to be in the original problem? In fact, maybe imagine those chords are kind of like elastic bands, and then maybe you can see now a solution to the original problem. Wishful thinking, great stuff, very powerful stuff. Thanks for watching. For more curriculum inspirations material, go to our website. Lots of great stuff there.